Welcome to another episode of Pokemon Violet, and you may be wondering why I'm over here. Well, that is the reason why. Plus, I was training other Pokemon, as well as my Pokemon. As you can see, I did a good chunk, so as always, after I get my Pokemon, I will do a I didn't finish, but oh well. I think these are good levels. Alright. Let's read the Pokédex and then we'll get the I'll get the swords. I found two of them, which is why I stayed over here. So, we're gonna go through the decks and read what I evolved. I still have plenty to go. Masquerain. The antennae have distinct patterns that look like eyes. When it rains, they grow heavy, making flight impossible. The eyeball Pokemon. Floatzel. It is a common sight around fishing ports. It is known to rescue people and help fishers carry what they caught. How helpful of Floatzel. Golduck finally evolved Psyduck. It swims gracefully along the quiet, slow-moving rivers and lakes of which it is so fond. I still haven't evolved Gallade, but that's because I don't have a Dawnstone. I will eventually get to Hypno. I'm gonna try and get Gengar, but you know, you gotta trade it. And Tandemouse, I'm going to record when I do that. Or at least the evolution. Finally evolved Vigoroth. This Pokemon lives lying on its side. It only rolls over and moves when there is no more grass to eat. Colossal. It's gentle usually, but fearsome when angered. With a body that burns over 2,700 degrees Fahrenheit, it crushes foes and turns them to ash. Luxio. By gathering their tails together, they collectively generate powerful electricity from their claws. Luxray. Luxray's ability to see through objects comes in handy when it's scouting for danger. Bearskewda. It swims at speeds of over 100 knots and battles fiercely with pods of finizen over prey. Interesting. Drifblim. They carry people and Pokemon, but the wind can catch them, so there can't be a fixed destination. Camerupt. If angered, the humps on its back erupt in a shower of molten lava. It lives in the craters of volcanoes. And yet, I can find them where I'm... Ah, shit. Where I'm at. Wiz Cash. Sighting Wiz Cash leaping from the water is believed to herald an earthquake. Vaporeon. Its cell composition is similar to water molecules. As a result, it can't be seen when it melts away into the water. I think I read that already. I read this one. Because we caught it. Rigoraf, I read that one. Muk. It's so stinky. Muk's body contains toxic elements, and any plant will wilt when it passes by. Toxtricity. Ant form. The jolt of electricity it launches by violently strumming the protrusions on its chest easily exceeds 15,000 volts. Loki form. As it gulps down stagnant water and generates electricity in its body, a sound like a rhythm played by a bass guitar reverberates all around. Amoongus. Amoongus mimics Pokeballs. It is not yet clear whether this mimicry is effective against other Pokemon. Electrode. It explodes in response to even minor stimuli. It is feared with the nickname of Bomb Ball. As you can see, I'm working on Ursaring. Go-Goat. These Pokemon live in herds in mountainous places. The victor in their contest of clashing horns will become leader of the herd. Zoroark. Each has the ability to fool a large group of people simultaneously. They protect their lair with illusory scenery. Gothitelle. It gazes at the stars to predict the future. It acts somewhat detached because it has seen the end of all existence. I still haven't gotten a Poltegeist. I'm seriously considering just catching one if I find one. Indeedy. I think I've read this one already. Fomantis. Many trainers give their Fomantis their own flower pot so they can sunbathe in peace and quiet. And then I did evolve it. A lot of time and effort is required to maintain the vivid colors of its petals. This Pokemon puts its trainer's attentiveness to the test. Cacturn. It lives in deserts. It becomes active at night when it hunts for prey exhausted from the desert's heat. Morgrem. This Pokemon absorbs negative emotions and turns them into energy. It's popular with people who tend to think gloomy thoughts. Grimmsnarl. It lives deep within the forest. Even after evolving into the splendid form, it hasn't given up on its petty misdeeds and pranks. I read this one, right? Revavroom viciously threatens others with the sound of its exhaust. It sticks its tongue out from its cylindrical mouth and sprays toxic fluids. I don't remember. Hawlucha. Hmm. talisman from the hollows in its arms. Its arms? Is it the two towers and the castle? It fires the dry bones of its victims, which are all dried up after being drained of their vitality. Okay, some of these ghost Pokemon are super duper dark. Luminion. Luminion swimming in the darkest of the deep sea looks like stars shining in the night sky. Toxapex. Toxapex gets into fierce battles with Bruxious over areas where warm ocean currents flow, but the odds are always against it. Frostmoth. It causes blizzards as it flies around with its huge, chill, emanating wings. Clean meltwater is its favorite thing to drink. Abomasnow. They appear when the snow flowers bloom. When the petals fall, they retreat to places unknown again. Beartic. Feared as the snow-white demon in the northern lands, Beartic uses its frosty claws and fangs to attack prey. Ice energy builds up in the horn on its upper jaw, causing the horn to reach cryogenic temperatures that freeze its surroundings. I think I read that, right? Yep, I did. Avalug. This Pokemon uses its massive icy body to flatten anything that gets in its way. When it's floating on the ocean, it looks exactly like drift ice. Yep, and I didn't even know that they could. Alright, and that's it. Now let's go get these swords so that we can go fight Cassiopeia. I didn't want to get the swords without recording, so. There's an ominous black stake driven into the ground when you pull out the stake. Yes. It crumbled and vanished. The other one is this way. I found it while training. I found both of them while training, actually. I was trying to find the last, trainer that I needed. I still haven't found the trainer, but I found the two swords. I think it's at the top of this mountain. Is that the trainer? Nope. Yeah, I was just training and exploring, and I found both of them, and I was like, oh. Well. Yes. Crumbled and vanished. Okay. Well, that's that. Let's go back to the Uva Academy. now that we've trained up and... Unfortunately, next episode will be the final exams. Maybe there. Ah, Miss Anna, how kind of you to stop by. I must say I'm pleased to see you at school grounds again. Travel and adventure certainly have their place, but it does one good to join class as well, no? Speaking of which, there is something I would very much like to ask you. I understand you have joined a variety of classes during your time here at the academy, but if I may ask, which of our faculty members has made the most favorable impression on you? Mr. Jacques, I think. Oh, Mr. Jacques from biology class, you say. Yes, he is a fine teacher, a most earnest and hardworking fellow. We are truly blessed to have so many wonderful teachers and staff members at U of A Academy. I firmly believe that our faculty is second to none in their commitment to our students' ongoing education and well-being. Thank you very much for sharing your thoughts, Miss Anna. Oh. Okay. So, not here. Do we have to go to the courtyard? Schoolyard. Here we go. Anna. It's Penny. Thanks for coming. My face. Heh, this must be quite a shock for you. The big boss, Cassiopeia. They were both me all along. When I saw you make quick work of those Team Star lackeys outside school that time, the idea for Operation Starfall suddenly came to me. My skills let me get hold of as much LP as I want, so I decided to use that to tempt you into helping me out. After the operation started, I kept an eye on you as a member of the supply unit, and I had you battle the bosses on my behalf. All for the goal of defeating me and putting an end to Team Star once and for all. But still, there's a part of me that wants Team Star to live on. I just can't roll over and let you win without putting up a fight. This is the final showdown. Are you ready? I'm ready. Thanks. I'm guessing you're an Eevee trainer from the backpack. At least that's what I'm thinking. Sorry to keep you. The letter of apology preparations took longer than expected. That voice. Are you Clive? Penny! So it was you after... is that you, Cassiopeia? In the flesh, I have a task for you, Clive, if you'll accept it. I want you to record what happens next so I can send the video to Team Star. They need to see the outcome of this battle for themselves. Okay. Will do. Then allow me to introduce myself properly. I'm the big boss of Team Star. The name's Cassiopeia. No, Penny. Now, bow down before the overwhelming might of Team Star's founder. Umbreon! I I won't hold back in this battle. I'll stay true to Team Star's code. Dark Pulse. Flareon, yep, she's a... I am so glad I trained up Veluza. I have a water Pokemon! Water Psychic is a much better typing than normal Psychic. I should have done it from the start. Hello, Flareon! 2 out of 6. I'm guessing you are an evolution trainer. Gonna use Leafeon, because if you are, I'm so using my Seralege. Jolteon. I'm still gonna use Seralege. I'm calm. Nope, that's not what I wanted. So let's send out our starter. Leafeon. Thought you had a Leafeon. Sylveon. It's so not fair, the advantage I have, but I can't fault you on your battle skills at all. No wonder the bosses fell at your hands. No, last one. Gigaton Hammer. Time to terrestrialize. Shine bright like the starry sky. Become who you really want to be. I'm guessing it's not going to be fairy type then. Nope, it's fairy type. I was wrong. One hit KO! crystallized. That's Gigaton Hammer for ya! It's all over now. 15,000? Damn! It's finally over, guys. It's done. We're done here. I think we should call it quits. Hold up. Are you saying we should break up the team? You gotta be joking. We got carried away with Operation Star. Now everything's gotten out of hand. Yeah, well, that's what happens when you round up a bunch of bullies in the courtyard and make a show of learning them some manners. But we didn't even fight them in the end. We didn't do anything wrong. Indeed, merely did we declare our intention to battle tooth and nail should the villains persist in their tyrannous oppression. It was a bloodless victory, we assure you. Yeah, they didn't even send out their Pokemon. They just blubbered and apologized a whole lot. Our outfits must have spooked them good. But the bullies made a huge stink about what went down, and then they all ended up leaving the academy. Our plan backfired epically. There's no way we're getting off scot-free. I guess you're right. This little stunt might have put us up the creek. I'll fix this mess on my end. Just leave it to me. What are you saying? I'm the one who started Team Star. I dragged you all into this. So I'll take responsibility for everything. Oh, noble and kind big boss, you cannot. Now that the bullies are gone, you guys should start going to school again. Oh yeah? And what about you? I can't go back. Why? There's no reason for you to stay shut in your room anymore, right? All I can say to you guys is thanks. Even though we never met in person, you were all so kind to me. Stop right there, BB. Why are you talking like we'll never speak again? I need to go take care of some things. Prithee, speak to us. What is thine intent? Hey, big boss, answer us. Bye, guys. Thanks for everything. Thanks for everything, Anna, and you too, Clive. I'm glad I could see this through to the end. I guess this is it for Team Star. And me, too. Hold that thought, Miss, Penny. I'd like to check something with you first. Check what? Why resort to something like Operation Starfall if you're the big boss of Team Star? Wasn't there any other way to handle this? I tried telling the bosses that we were done once before, but they still didn't quit. Why not simply order them to? Our code states that no one in the team has the right to order people around. I could ask them all to do stuff, but I could never order them. So it's back to the code once again. The bosses must have taken it very seriously. They did. That's why I knew I could use it to force Team Star to disband. Because the bosses would do anything the code required of them? Even leave the team? Yes. And according to the code, they had to accept any challenge made to them. Thus, the idea for Operation Starfall. Cassiopeia. Let me ask you one last thing. What does Team Star know? What do your friends in the team mean to you? They're my greatest treasure. Splendid. Thank you for apprising me of the situation, Miss Penny. What? No, young lady, there's something I should very much like to discuss with you. Hey, quit with the old geezer at Clive. You're creeping me out. Indeed. Well then, before we talk further, allow me to reveal to you my own secret identity. Ha ha! Director Clavel? Just as Cassiopeia was your disguise, the boy you knew as Clive was mine. But why? I needed a way to talk to Team Star on equal terms. Students do tend to shy from speaking their mind to their teachers after all, much more so when they're faced with the director of the academy. Yes, but where do I even start? Wasn't the outfit a bit much? Plus, I have some big feelings about that wig.
Me too, Penny.
Me too. Ahem, that's quite enough of that for now. Everyone, why don't you come on out? Hey, look, it's the bosses of Team Star. Yo, big boss, long time no see. Momo. More like long time no meet, right? I mean, we just, well, just found out your real name just now. Melly. Verily is thy long hidden countenance a sight for sore eyes, my lady. Atticus. So, I heard your real name's Penny. How have you been this whole time? Artie. We found you at last. You've no idea how worried we've been. Ari. Okay, gang, on the count of three. One, two, hasta la vista, Castillo, and hello, Penny. That's cute. Now then, Miss Penny, and each of you young bosses as well. On behalf of the Academy, I have something I would like to say to Team Star. You all have my sincerest apologies. Come again. As director of the Academy, I let you down. My handling of your situation was a dismal failure. What? Why? You all told me about your reasons for forming Team Star and about your subsequent actions. Ever since my first days as director, all I've experienced of the Academy's environment blessedly free from bullying. But now I know that this piece was built on the backs of your hurt and anger, and of course your immense courage in putting things right. And so I'll get straight to the conclusion. The Academy's order for Team Star to disband and my threat to expel those who did not obey are hereby revoked. Does that mean what I think it means? Indeed, Team Star can continue to exist, should that be your wish. Woohoo! Penny, isn't this great? Now we can all stay together! Oh, my heart is giddy with glee. But I betrayed all of you. You mean Operation Starfall? Director Clavel told us all about it. For as we heard, you only went through with it to save us from getting expelled. You were just worried about us, right? Not like we'd ever chuck the team just because someone told us to, after all. Ain't our style. I cannot even begin to imagine how you must have feared for us, Lady Penny. Sorry for making you worry, BB. We're all okay now. But even so. Hold on, everyone. I've more to say. As previously stated, the requirement for Team Star to disband has been revoked. However, there are still some unsettled matters to discuss. Allow me to provide a few examples. Your protracted truancy, your brazen customization of school uniforms, your unauthorization usage of Academy equipment, your reckless modification and jeopardous driving of Pokemon-powered vehicles. Need I go on? Your flagrant disregard for school rules cannot simply be overlooked. Oh, their faces. Thus, as punishment, you will all be required to engage in community service. Community service? Yes, specifically, I will be asking you to manage the STCs. And that stands for the Star Training Centers. They shall be facilities for cultivating Pokemon trainers' talents. I plan for the Academy to found them in collaboration with the Pokemon League. The idea came to me when I saw Miss Anna battling her way through your bases. The base's construction, as well as the battle tactics employed by the students in Team Star, are remarkably unique and creative. I would ask you that you continue your team's activities, but henceforth as STC staff members, using your former bases as training facilities. And that is the sum of it. Does anyone have any concerns? No. It sounds like fun, so I don't see how this be anything but a win-win. This may be a weird thing to say, but since the STCs are supposed to be a punishment and all, but you should totally join in too, Penny. 'Tis true. We would most happily have you at our sides, my lady. We can go to school together, too. That way, if anything happens, we'll be there to protect you. We were already talking about how great it'd be to have both Team Star and school in our lives. This would be a sweet deal for us. So, what do you say? You guys. Anna, what do you think? I think it sounds great. Huh? No need to give your response right this moment, Miss Penny. Do take some time to decide. For now, at least, I think our little group should go their separate ways. Not to say you should break up Team Star after all. I simply meant it is time to leave. Miss Anna, please stop by my office later, if you would. Alright, let's do this. Ah, here you are, Miss Anna. I wanted to thank you for all your hard work in resolving the situation with Team Star. If not for you, I suspect I would have done the team a grievous injustice in my choice of punishment for their actions. You have my sincere gratitude. Knock, knock, knock. Who is it? It's Penny. Ah, Miss Penny, do come in. Hello, Director. About the STCs, I'd like to work on them together with the rest of Team Star. That's wonderful news. Thank you very much for your favorable response. But, I should be punished more heavily than the others, I think. Why so? Because of Operation Starfall? No, not that. Because of the other really bad thing I did. And what would that be? You know that LP I gave you both in exchange for helping me with Operation Starfall? I got hold of it sort of illegally by hacking the Pokemon League's LP management system. Ah, I see. That is quite the revelation. I did not think such a thing was even possible in the first place. It wasn't all that hard. I'm really sorry and I won't do it again. This matter is out of my jurisdiction, I'm afraid. I will have to consult Miss Gita, the Pokemon League chairwoman, on how best to proceed. I figured as much. I do apologize, Miss Anna, but I will have to ask you to give us some privacy. Okay. Maybe the schoolyard? No? Okay, Thank you. Hey there, come on in. Everyone's welcome in the nurse's office. Anna, have you toughened up a bit?
Yup.
Oh, so you know your tough stuff, huh? But seriously, you look a bit different. I bet it's because of all the crazy experiences you're having on your treasure hunt. You need to tell me all about what you've been up to. Wow, that's super cool. I sure am jealous of you kids. You get to try out new things every single day. Me, on the other hand, I actually wanted to become a teacher. I'm just a school nurse, you know. I can't teach classes or anything like that. I couldn't pass the certification exam to become an actual health teacher. I took it so many times, but no luck. So here I am, stuck forever in the nurse's office. Sorry, I guess this isn't a very fun thing to talk about. But you're just such a good listener. I find myself telling you all kinds of stuff. I hope you'll still come to see me, even if I talk your ear off like this. Trying to... Yes, Anna, from one class 1A. The way you conduct yourself in my class and the answers you give to my questions, I admit they pique my interest. You are quite the interesting pupil, I must say. Tell me, Anna, given a choice, which do you prefer? Things of old or things that are new? I like new stuff, but I also do like older stuff. Ah, so you prefer the things of the past, do you? The potential I saw in you was real after all. Yes, this one may be indeed of good use to me someday. What? Ah, you can disregard that. I was simply thinking out loud. I enjoyed our little conversation today. You have my thanks, Anna. Oh my, if it isn't Anna. Hello there. Do you perhaps have a question about class? I do have a question. What were you having trouble with? Let's have a little review here, shall we? Oh no, flying types, monarch type, it's doubled. Yes, that's correct. The answer is the move's damage is doubled. Miss Time! Oh my, I see one of my more energetic students is here to see me. You'll have to wait your turn, dear. There is only one of me after all. Miss Time, is it true that you were a gym leader? That is indeed true. I'm quite the strong battler, you know. Wow, that's so cool. Why'd you quit? So you want to know, do you? I might be persuaded to tell you if you wait your turn. Okay, I can wait my turn. I sure can. I'm sorry for cutting our conversation short, Anna, but I seem to be in high demand today. Feel free to come see me anytime if you have questions for me. Wasn't there one more? Oh, Anna! Did you come all the way here to the staff room just to see me? Sure. Aha! Seems I finally made it into the hearts of my students. That makes me thrice happy. After all, like I said in class, communication is very important. If there's anything you're confused about in class, or if you're having trouble here at the academy, you can always come here and tell me. Tone me, Salvatore. Your friend, Salvatore, that is. Always. I am terrible in this language class. Let's try going back into the courtyard. Ooh, entrance hall. There we go. There's something I want to talk to you about. Alright, here we go. Could you meet me in front of the school stairs? You know, where we first met? I'll be waiting. I just want to finish the story, if it is finished. Hasta la vista. The six of us thought that catchphrase up back when we created the team. It's so cringy, it's perfect, you know? Anyway, about the LP thing. I thought I was going down big time for hacking the league point system, but they're letting me off easy. That's great. The Pokemon League said they'll waive my debt if I do some volunteer engineering for them. They even asked me to come work for them after I graduate, if you can believe that. Dr. Clavel and that Gita lady kept complimenting me, like, a weird amount. Apparently, I have outstanding talent or something. Sorry for calling you out here to meet like this. I'm still not so great with people face to face. I never seem to find the right words, but, thank you so much. You saved Team Star and my friends along with it. I know words won't ever be enough to properly thank you for all you've done, so here. Draco Meteor! Awesome! I'm sure you'll put this to good use. And one more thing. I want to repay the debt I owe you. If you ever think of a way I can do that, just let me know. I'm great with machines and hacking and stuff. So next time, I'll be the one helping you, Anna. Be seeing you then. Hasta la vista. Yay! I completed Starfall Street! Alright. Well, on that note, I'm gonna go back into the academy. Because next time, we're gonna do our final exams while we're here. And then after that, we will take on the Pokemon League. Alright, so this is where we're gonna stop. And Friday, we will be doing our final exams so that we can concentrate on the Pokemon League and exploring more after. And it'll probably be a boring one, so if you don't want to watch, you can. But there is a lot of interesting stuff in these classes. I learned some stuff that I didn't even realize I didn't know. And I've been playing Pokemon for a very long time. But there is also another thing I wanted to discuss. Me and my husband used a small portion of our taxes to get a PS5 and to get Hogwarts Legacy. Now, I don't have the pre-order bonus, but I did get the deluxe edition, mostly because I wanted to see the bonus stuff, exclusive stuff, but I was wondering if you guys wanted me to wait till I got the Xbox One version, where I do have the pre-order bonus, or if you wanted me to play on the PS5. And which house? I am currently playing one, and I picked Slytherin because it was one of my least likely houses and I wanted to do something different. I am thinking of doing a Dark Wizard, but I want it to be from an unexpected house. So let me know down in the comments below if you'd rather me play on the Xbox One or the PS5 for Hogwarts Legacy. Now on the PS5 I won't have the pre-order bonus, but I do have the deluxe edition, so I do have that bonus rewards. So yeah. But if I do play on the PS5, I won't be doing it until at least I complete all the stories for Pokemon Violet. Because and at least until I've completed most of the Pokédex and read at least all the things, or at least done it to where it'll take me a while and I can, because I have to hook up a system, I have to hook something up to the PS5 to make sure I get it to record. So yeah, if it's possible, so let me know, and I will see you guys Friday for final exams, and then after that we'll take on the Pokemon League, and yeah, hopefully soon we can finish Pokemon Violet, and I'm sorry that it has taken so long, but with only 2 days to record it out of the 3 days I'm doing, it's gonna take a little while. So we'll see you next time, and let me know what you guys think. Like I said, if I do it on the PS5, it won't be until I at least finish all the storylines. And stuff. So yeah. I think in the meantime, while I have it hooked up, I'm gonna try and get all the new Scarlet and Violet forms so that I can just do one video with the old Pokemon to read from the Pokedex. So I'll be working on that while I have it set up. So alright, well, I'm gonna stop recording and get this loaded up. But yeah, let me know about Hogwarts Legacy, because I will be recording that. I haven't got very far in it, but let me know, and comment down below, and leave a like, and subscribe if you haven't already, because whether it's Harry Potter, or in this case Hogwarts Legacy, Skyrim, or Pokemon as of right now, there's more coming your way. So yeah. We'll see you next time.